I'm sure you've heard PAFs are the cleanest selections you can get in Photoshop, but they can be so difficult. Let me show you how to automatically create them. So there's some hidden features in Photoshop, and to access them, you want to go to the Preferences. And then you're going to go to Technology Previews. And you'll see there's features in here that may not actually be turned on. One of them is Content Aware Tracing. So let's turn that on, click OK. Now you need to restart Photoshop for this to work, which I've already done. So we're going to go down to the pen tool and click and hold, and you'll see Content Aware Tracing. Let's turn this on. I'll also link to my comprehensive tutorial on using the pen tool. Okay, the next thing we need to do is set the amount of detail. If we click on this detail slider and we slide, we can see we can get extremely detailed or very undetailed. So let's move this up so mostly we see our outline, and there might be a couple of little gaps, but don't worry about that. So we're there at 14%. Now we're going to change the tracing to simplified. All right. Now, as we roll over, what you'll see is, see how those areas appear? Now, it's not going to get it all in one go, so I don't want to be a spoiler. But what we're going to do is we're going to start here. We're going to click. And then we're going to click there. And let's just go around some of these areas to get our selection. All right. Now, don't worry too much about the hair, because we're going to get this separately. And see how it's a little bit more kind of detailed stuff going on here? We might want to change this to detailed now. And this will give us a little bit more detail in some of these areas. Okay, we've made the rough selection. Now we need to clean it up. Let's go under the pen tool. And then we're going to choose the regular pen tool. All right, see, we've got some gaps in here, so we need to clean these up. Okay, what we want to do now is we want to combine these or join these. So we're just going to grab the end here, and then we're just going to start to drag out. And I'm just going to create an area around the hair because we're going to fix that later. And then just click on that point there, and that will complete it. So let's go around here. Now I need to fix this. So this will turn to a minus. So we're just going to hit that little minus tool to get rid of the areas we don't want. Just getting rid of those extra points. And then from here, let's just drag an extra point in so we can join those. And we're going to come back in a sec. We'll fix all this. All I want to do is join it right now. I see here this needs to be joined. So let's grab there. And where would we join it to? We'll join it to there. We've obviously got some points to get rid of. So we're just going to hit the little minus. See how it becomes a minus key when we're over there? And we can just zoom in and get rid of all these extra points. Now, if we want to see if the path is completely closed, we can hold down the Control or Command key and click on Work Path. So when we see something like this, that means something's broken there and something's going to be broken over here too. So Control D will turn off that selection, and we can see where it's broken. Yep. Once again, Control click. I see that's working. It's broken up here. Okay, when we zoom in nice and close, we can see, yep, let's close that up. Okay, Control click on the work path. All right, that looks good. So now what we're going to do is we're going to fix that path. So we're going to click on the path to select it. All right, and to clean it up, we're going to grab the Add Anchor Point tool. And then we can go into these areas. And you can see, you know, hey, something's weird here. So if I click on a point, it will show the handles. So I can take the handles, and all I got to do is pull them in, because in the situations like that, that usually means the handles are dragged out too much. But if we look in here, see what we've got? We can drag these in. And sometimes we have an additional one. If we hold the Alt or the Option key, we can click, and that will get rid of that additional point. And now we can just untangle it. Now, if we want to move one side by itself, hold down the Alt or Option key and drag, and notice now we can just unwind it and get it going back the right way. Click and drag on the point. Just click on the path, and that will reselect it. Great. Click to add a point. So just remember, everything moves around the points. And then these little handles enable us to shape it. So it looks like we've got a little bit of an extra kind of a path going on here. If I select it and then I just hit the delete key, we can delete that extra path. But it looks like this is where the problem is. So we're going to hit that minus and we just want to combine those again. So go back to the pen tool and we just click to add these. It's just like a game. It's like a puzzle. And see if you can guess what's wrong with this one. Yeah, the handles are too long. So if we just click on one of the points, you'll see these big long handles. Grab that long, long handle, pull it up, and just go the other way. See what you're doing? You're literally just flipping the direction of it. Both sides are moving, don't want that. Remember, Alt-Option splits it. There we go. Now we've got it going the right way. Okay, let's test this by Control-Click. Yep, that's going to give us a nice path. Looks like there's a little bit up there we want to fix. Let's click back on Work Path. Control D will turn that off. Too many points. Hold down the Alt or the Option key, goes to the minus. Let's get rid of those additional points and shorten those handles. I'm going to hold down Alt Option because I only want that one side. Same with the other side. See, it's really not that difficult once you get the hang of it, it's actually not that hard. Control click. Looking good. So let's go into our layer, and now I'm just going to create a layer mask. See, when you get in close, look at this, the beautiful, crisp, sharp edge that you're going to get from the pen tool or the paths. Now, it's not going to do hair. All right, we need to fix that little bit of hair. So why don't we select the layer, and then we're going to go into select a mask. And here we are in Select a Mask, and we're going to grab our little hair tool. And let's just paint over here. Notice as we do this, we can clean up these edges. And for large areas like that, just grab the Solid tool, hold down the Alt or the Option key, and then we can just paint that away. Looks awesome. Change that to selection and click OK. Now we've got our selection. What we want to do is inverse our selection so we can paint outside it. So choose select, inverse, grab the mask, grab a brush with black, and we just paint away. So if you've ever created paths manually, you'll know this just saved a lot of time. And I chose a pretty complex subject because I wanted to show something a little bit more difficult than just using a very simple shape. So I'm kind of curious, is this a tool you would use? Let me know in the comments underneath. And if you're new or you haven't yet subscribed, hit the subscribe button, turn on notifications, you won't miss any of my tutorials. Do me a favor, hit that like button. And until next time, I'll see you at the cafe.